Hey everyone, One Big Boss here, and interesting little note that dropped to me today. Capcom has acquired yet again they renewed the license for Devil May Cry. Now, this means they have the title for Devil May Cry, hence why I'm wearing this shirt, which, oddly enough, I put this on after coming home from work before I read the message from a friend of mine. Now, this in many ways is a good thing. I think that bringing back Devil May Cry would actually be something beneficial to Capcom. So you all know Capcom's been going through a lot of crap the last couple of years. A lot of things have been mismatched, misdone, and games just in general that were supposed to be good have really not. At this point, Capcom pretty much just has Street Fighter and Monster Hunter working for them. But the Devil May Cry series originally was one of their best-selling games of all time. And it was a phenomenal series. And, you know, Devil May Cry 1, unbelievable. Number 2 was so bad in a way that, like, it took everything that was great about the first game and they kind of just, like, went with the second one. They made up for that, though, when they made Devil May Cry 3, and which is arguably, actually, it's not arguably, this is probably the best, it is the best game out of the Devil May Cry series. And then 4 came out, and 4 got a graphical boost, big time, thanks to the power of the PS3 and the Xbox 360. And sale-wise, Capcom's numbers, Devil May Cry 4 was a commercial success, but unfortunately with the fans, it was not that good. Now, what you also have to remember with these big Japanese companies is they all want to make a profit off of every game these days. This is not new. This is something that we've seen pretty much since 2009, 2010, especially with a company like Capcom. Now, they do look at their numbers, and so they, for some odd reason, they decided, you know, we're going to do something different. Ninja Theory comes in, they do the Devil May Cry reboot, and unfortunately, it's not that good. Even Capcom said that their sales for it were not nearly what they expected. It sold well, but not near what they wanted. Now, I am unfortunately not one of those people. I gave the new Devil May Cry game a chance, I really did, and unfortunately, I just couldn't get into it. I played through it, and it just wasn't my game. But I understand if people do like it that never played the original Devil May Cry series. But when you've built an empire on an amazing series like that, and then swap it up, change the character completely, you can understand why it's not going to work. You know, Resident Evil kind of did that. They took a turn. They took a turn from survival horror, and they aimed it towards the action genre, and they tried to make it like a Michael Bay film, pretty much just to get a bunch of Call of Duty fanboys to start playing their game, because they saw how good the Call of Duty series was doing. So they changed it up to bring that genre of people into the survival horror or Resident Evil series. That's like making Mega Man a different person, which is technically what they're doing with Mighty No. 9. It's like the spiritual successor. But regardless, you can see where I'm coming from with this. I would personally like to see old Dante come back, as I think that they could do a lot with it, because the Devil May Cry series have also sparked an amazing amount of characters. While the original 4 Devil May Cry games, the story for each game was not really explored that much, there wasn't much detail, they were such over-the-top action-heavy that it was okay that you didn't need a plot, but it also made you want to know more about the characters. And in 4, there was kind of more of a story to it a little bit. 3 had a decent story where it was just, you know, the brothers fighting and, you know, a few other things were learned about the game series. So I think, like, that an actual proper Devil May Cry 5 would be good, where you could have Virgil, Dante, and Nero in it. Because, you know, there's something about Nero that, you know, they never touched on it. People are, like, suggesting that he might be Virgil's son somehow or whatever. Either way, I think it's pretty cool that they have that Capcom has the title for for Devil May Cry now. Which, hopefully, that does good. Now, the thing about Ninja Theory with the Devil May Cry reboot, what they did well was the way that the game played and controlled, it actually felt a little bit better than the other Devil May Cry games. Now, Devil May Cry 4 was actually handled really well. Its combat system was pretty good, but unfortunately, it wasn't well received by fans for a lot of different reasons. But that doesn't mean that Capcom should have given the plug and started a reboot. Now, I know a lot of people like the new Dante and the new Virgil, and personally, I do actually like the new Virgil. I think his character, as much as it was an overhaul, this was before he pretty much became twisted and all that stuff, and then we saw Virgil's downfall. So, either way, what is Capcom planning to do with the Devil May Cry title again, now that they've renewed it? Like, are they just going to let it sit on the shelf and collect dust, or Are they going to make some games, and what are the games going to be for? Now, I think with the next-gen systems, I think they could really push the limits and give us an amazing over-the-top action game like the original Devil May Cry games. I think if they maybe ask Ninja Theory to come back and use the old group of characters like Trish, Lady, Nero, Dante, Vergil, all those characters, I think it would be something good. Other than that, I think they would look pretty. I think it would look pretty good on the next gen systems. But I digress, because we don't know exactly what they're doing. As long as Capcom doesn't devote more time to the mobile market. Now, I had made a video about this, I think about 2 months ago or so, and it was talking about how Capcom was going to spend pretty much half all the profits they made on the Monster Hunter series to forward it to mobile gaming. And unfortunately, mobile gaming is not the way to go. I've explained this before. Mobile gaming went out fast in like 2009, 2010. So, and that's unfortunately what they did with the Breath of Fire titles. They're making one for tablets and mobile gaming. So hopefully, the Devil May Cry series, whether it be the old Dante series and the new Dante, hopefully we do not see them go the way of mobile gaming, because that's just a way to kill a franchise completely. Because we all remember that horrible Mega Man one they made that was on mobile, and it was just horrible. So, as always, I want to know what you people think about this whole situation. Is this, are we going to get a new Devil May Cry game for the next gen at one point, or are they just going to keep the title, or is the next DMC game going to be a continuation off of DMC itself? Only time will tell, I guess. But what do you guys think? What would you personally like to see? Would you like to see them work on two Devil May Cry games? You know, Devil May Cry 5 and DMC 2? Because, I mean, we already got an HD remix, so it's not like they can do that again. So, as always, just sign off in the bottom in the comments. Let me know what you all think about this. You know my thoughts on it, so I look forward to hearing yours. So, everybody, thanks for watching. Hit the thumbs up. Hit the subscribe button, because I appreciate it. It's kind of, you know, it's free. This day and age, free is a damn good thing. So, as always, thanks everybody for watching. I'm One Big Boss, and I'll see you all next time.